small green stone, which is the heart of the island goddess Tefiti, was stolen by Maui, demigod of the wind and sea, giving birth to a terrible darkness. When Maui made his escape, he was attacked by Teka, a demon of earth and fire, who also sought the heart for its power of creation. Maui was struck from the sky, causing both the heart of Tefiti and his power-granting magic fishhook to be lost to the sea. Thousands of years later, young Moana, daughter of the chief on the island of Motunui, is called on by the ocean to restore Tefiti's heart after a plague hits the island. She seeks to restore balance and harmony to the island and the wayfinding traditions of her people.
It's too dangerous over there.
But if we explore beyond the reef, then
it's too dangerous.
We need to explore beyond the reef. What about the fish?
Too dangerous.
So many fish. Darkness is spreading on our island. Dad, we have to. We have to explore beyond the reef.
For the last time, you're not going to leave this island.
Moana's grandmother, Grandma Tala, presents Moana with the heart of Tefiti and with her dying breaths, pleads with her to set sail. Her threshold guardian is her overprotective father, Chief Tui, who tries to prevent Moana from embarking on this dangerous quest, insisting that her true calling is on the island. He soon realizes that she is meant to complete this mission, and Moana finally sets sail into the ocean, entering the unknown world.
I am Moana of Montenegro. You, Maui, will board my boat and restore the heart of Tefiti.
Moana endures many trials and tribulations during her journey. After a large typhoon wave flips her boat and knocks her unconscious, she finds herself washed up on an island with Maui, who traps her inside a cave and steals her sailboat to search for his magical fishhook. Moana catches up and tries to convince Maui to help her return the heart, but he initially refuses. While they sail, they stumble across angry, violent, coconut-shaped monsters called kakamoras, who are also after the heart of Tefiti. After escaping the kakamoras, Moana and Maui must venture into the realm of monsters to retrieve Maui's magical fishhook. They find it in the cave of Tamatoa, a large treasure-hoarding coconut crab whom they successfully evade through trickery. Maui becomes Moana's helper teaching her how to sail and navigate. When they arrive at Tafiti's island, they are attacked by Taka, who damages Maui's fish hook and repels their boat.
Okay. We're gonna set course over there. And we're changing course.
You're welcome.
Hey, wait.
Bye, Moana. I'm gonna go get my hook, and you can't do anything about it.
Maui, wait. You have to restore the heart of Tafiti.
No.
You have to restore the heart of Tafiti.
No.
Please.
No.
Please.
No.
Please.
No. Why am I stuck with you?
Hey Maui, what are those?
Those are kakamoras.
Kind of cute. Don't you think? Oh! They're after the heart of Tafiti. We have to stop them.
Okay, so here's the plan. So I go get my hook and you check.
Why don't you go?
You
just go get your hook.
I don't want to do it alone, so can you give me the direction?
Just go. Hello? There's no one here. Just go get your hook.
Oh, look. What do we have here? You want the hook? Come get it. Oh. Nope. Look at what I have. The heart of Tafiti. I have it. Wait, this is a fake. Hey, come back here!
Teach me how to sail?
Maui abandons Moana out of fear that fighting the fire monster again will destroy his magical fish hook. Moana is visibly distressed and nearly quits. She tosses the heart into the ocean and pleads it to choose another person to return it to Tafiti. The scene takes place in a dark, raging storm, which indicates that Moana has lost all hope and is at her lowest point.
Maui, please, wait. You have to restore the heart.
Put one more blow on my hook and it'll be destroyed, and I'm nothing without it.
Maui, please.
I'm so done with you.
someone else.
Right as Moana is deciding to turn back, the spirit of Grandma Tala appears to her, who encourages Moana that she is the rightful person to restore the heart. Thus, Moana's mentor is the spirit of the ocean and her grandmother, who both guide her towards fulfilling her quest and continually remind her of its purpose. Moana jumps into the ocean, retrieves the heart, and sets sail for Tahiti once again.
Grandma, Moana, I missed you.
I missed you too. You're a long ways from the reef.
Grandma, who am I?
You're Moana, and the ocean chose you.
The ocean chose me.
The ocean chose me.
After the reassurance of Grandma Tala, Moana is more determined than ever to restore the heart and save her people. She now understands it is her destiny to understand and answer the will of the ocean. Maui, having experienced a revelation of his own, returns and distracts Taka while Moana approaches in her sailboat. Maui's fishhook is destroyed in the battle that ensues.
Come on, Hei-Hei. Let's go find Taka.
I am Moana of Matsunui, and I will restore the heart of Tahiti.
Moana!
Maui!
Moana, you have to restore the heart of Tahiti.
Moana realizes that Taka is actually Tahiti without her heart. She sees past the rough exterior of the fire demon and through song reminds the goddess of her true identity. This demonstrates her newfound empathy, and she is fully at one with herself.
There's no island.
Hey, Taka!
Stolen the heart from inside you, but this does not define you. This is not who you are. You know who you are.
After Moana presents the heart to Taka, she transforms into Tahiti. In gratitude, Tahiti bestows upon Maui a new magical fishhook and gifts Moana a new canoe before returning to her island form. Moana bids an emotional goodbye to Maui and returns to Motunui, where she finds it has been restored and thriving with life. Moana succeeds her father as chief and imparts her newfound wisdom on her people, leading them to become explorers and navigators once again.
God is to be.
New hook. Thank you.